Puttekar.
Puttekar.
Yes.
All of them make a reference to the particular question. Now, I will also write it upon the revision. My Lord said that at that point of time, the law was not settled. It was still fluid. In fact, my Lord, whether the state can agency that have the power to have to do some classification or to include other castes within the scheduled caste or not was not still settled. It was settled only in the village case. In fact, my Lord, in the village case, this court had not granted a stay. It was revealed from a revision minister of the Maharashtra of the Bombay High Court, which stated that the state do have the power. So only after 2001 judgment, this particular circular of 2001 happens to be issued, wherein the state says that as I do not have the power in the light of the decision of the Honorable Appeals Court, you please surrender the certificate. We will protect your employment, but you shall not take any future benefits out of the same. Right. In person to the same, we surrender the same. After a period of another 10 years, the state comes up with another circular stating that we shall extend this benefit shall be extended only to the state government but not to the central government. And consequently, a departmental inquiry was initiated. Throughout the repetition, writ appeal, and the during the pendency of this SLP, I have been granted the benefit of the order. In fact, I have also been allowed to retire. Now, I know.
All of you are superannuated?
Yes, we are all superannuated, but our pension and retirement benefits are not in that.
Okay. So you have taken heart after hearing our responses to the other matters, yes, to argue it. We are relieved to hear that.
I will sort to be led by Mr. K.
Sometimes you don't need to be led. But anyway, your colleague has argued it. You are virtually the same thing, except that you've all superannuated.
Yes, ma'am.
And your employer is Canara Bank.
Yes.
Mr. Mehta, what would you have to say?
In so far as recovery is concerned, they are not concerned with, but okay, not super
not recovery. That sense, but pension and all of that.
There is no question.
Why?
Two judgments of this court, three judge benches, Malone. I've said there is no question.
Can we have a look at
this?
Let's have the benefit of
first, Malone.
You filed them? Have you filed
this? This is Malone, 2004.
These judgments have been filed by the petitioner. You haven't filed anything. You haven't filed anything, Mr. Mehta.
No, I have not filed judgments.
But in fact, the judgment relies on the Karnataka High Court, Bahira judgment, specifically addresses those categories of people who have already retired during the pendency. As regards those people, it specifically states that this cannot apply.
Where is it that, Bahira?
Balram
Bahira. Which yes, one? At number 10 of your compendium?
Page 10.
Serial number 10.
Page 10.
Mehta is referring to which judgment first?
That's a three judges bench. You do, but maybe ask the petitioner, are you referring to chairman, manager?
Chairman, manager. Yes.
So let's have it. Let's have time.
Is there with us. Available?
Is here.
Can I show Vishwanath Pillai first, Malam? Because specific argument on retirement benefits was made, Malam.
Let's see. Is it a case wherein the certificates were cancelled after the appointment? Let's come to that point first. Let us see.
Where are the facts?
Yes.
Look at the facts.
Yes, look at the facts.
False caste certificate. Please address us on that. How do you call these certificates to be false? Tell us.
The Lordships have said, Malone, in an umpteen number of cases that Malone, insofar as presidential order, Malone, issued on 340 and 341, no state can and nobody can tinker with it. You have to see that.
Are these citizens supposed to go and inquire whether the state has the power to issue the certificate or not?
Where?
Yes, it's still we are entitled to put your question, Mr. Mehta. Yes. Yes.
Karnataka itself has issued a GO that the benefits which we are giving, my Lord, cannot be made applicable to central PSUs. That's one. Two, my Lord, there is an office memorandum of Ministry of Finance, my Lord, so that, my Lord,
we just read the OM of 2005. It says for future purposes, the certificates will not be required.
Yes. This question, please have a look at
Balot 2.
Would
your
lordship have item 16 for a minute?
Yes. First, let us see Vishwanath Pillai. How the court holds the certificate to be false. Yes. Let's come to that only.
Yes.
Yes.
See, my Lord.
False certificate. Let's see. Which Kara?
110, my Lord.
Yes. Any declaration in the present set of cases that the caste certificates were false? Any authority has said so? We are asking you, Mr. Mehta, false certificate, please. Is a difference.
Their surrendering is on a
certificate becoming invalid at a later date. Find the certificate being false at the inception by two different things. Yes.
First, let's get our facts correct.
Yeah.
First, just to ask you, you are in 16 and 16.3, right? You are in 16.3. So just let us add. Now here, there is no dispute that when the certificates were issued, they did not misrepresent to the authority. The certificates were issued at that time, that particular category, by the state government in its wisdom.
That is true. That is correct. That is correct.
It's not a case of a
competent authority.
Competent authority. By the state. So it was not as if they misrepresented.
They claimed and were granted.
They claimed on the basis of...
Just hold on. Come to Vishwanath Pillai. Please, para 4, Prasitam E. Prasitam D, D and E. Please read that. We'll get the answer there and there. Then and there. Yes.
The appellant obtained a
certificate.
All right, the caste.
Yes.
It doesn't matter.
The caste Vishwanath Pillai was reported as Vishwanath Pillai. His father was one so and so. He was the Nayak. His mother's caste was so and so. Nayak as well as so and so are forward caste. The caste of the brother and the two sisters, the school record was also recorded as belonging to forward caste. The appellant obtained a community certificate from Tehsildar stating he was a member of the Vetuan community. On the basis of this certificate, he was able to get appointment as assistant in the legislative secretariat in the year 73 against a post reserved for scheduled caste. In the year 77, he was selected as director the post of deputy superintendent in the police against the seat reserved for scheduled caste on the basis of caste from the certificate obtained by him. He was subsequently promoted, including the cadre of ITS. Government of Kerala, on the basis of complaint received, ordered a full-fledged anthropological inquiry into the caste status of the appellant. It was alleged that the appellant did not belong to the scheduled
caste. Facts are entirely different.
Entirely different.
Great respect, Malone. Please see, Malone, just because, Malone, the government of Karnataka, on the application of Malone, a particular individual, issues a
caste. Not the individual. It is
the whole lot,
a particular set of communities. Yes.
So there was no such inquiry required in cases of the whole lot. Nobody is denying they weren't of that caste. They were given a particular recognition by the state of Karnataka. How can you compare them with this? And just one more request to your colleague sitting at the back. We don't see ourselves traveling beyond item 20. It's already 20 to 1. All the rest of the council will check up the status of the matters post to. You can leave. As far as we are concerned, this will take at least that much of time. Not beyond 20. If the council want to leave, be free. Yes, Mr. Mehta.
Yes, my lord. My lord, I will show the order of the single judge also. But my lord, the point is this, my lord.
Point is, R. Vishwanath Pillai is totally distinguishable.
But I, yes. Since the driving perspective.
Of course.
I know your lordship are always open. My lord, I will show the documents from the record, my lord. Please have a look at the state government circular at page 82. They made it very clear, my lord, that what they are saying.
Page 82.
Page 82, my lord, is a circular issue for the government.
14611.
My lord, this is.
14611.
Yes, 42. Now, please come to page 85, my lord, if your lordship don't mind, and see para 4. And then your lordship will see what those references are. Para 4 and page 85.
Yes, not applicable to those employed in the
yes.
Government of India agency. Now, this is my lord, page 87. Government of India is issued.
Pause here for a moment. When did he come on board?
He, 79-80, my lord. 79-80. I'm not saying no, my lord.
So just to recall.
Yes, that's why I said, my lord, I'm not talking about recovery. But my lord, today, to say, my lord, that even though, my lord, the was not plotted in accordance with the presidential order.
Oh. Entirely... We really fail to understand. Whether the passive office for the certificate is going to the validity of the presidential order, you expect us to believe that?
When you apply, certificate, yes. Obviously you have to see whether that caste is mentioned there in the presidential order or not.
What are the authorities?
Let's pass on the blame to him. Take the blame equally.
The bank accepted.
You should have, you are a public sector undertaker. Mr. Mehta, We're not too sure if your heart is in this matter. You may be arguing it is all right.
87.
And this is what an office memorandum issued by government. The government of India says state has no power to modify the list of scheduled caste. Understood.
And citizens cannot be deemed to be scheduled caste.
But the citizen is supposed to
say that please take action.
Let's come to 2005 circular, which was just read. Please come. 52.
In which, not in my
same, yes, paper, same, same paper. 52 is Panexture P8.
Yes.
17-8-2005. History of Finance, Banking Division.
The government of India. Yes.
And it talks of
who has issued it, sir? Mehta, who has issued it?
Central government. Ministry of Finance.
Yes, subsequent. When did they retire? Please tell us.
1920.
What?
The relevant date, would be the date they entered service.
Yes, sir.
Now read this. 8-4.
Para 4.
In this case, clarified various scheduled castes has been rescheduled, denotified after appointment in the bank. Concerned employee may be treated as a general category employee and the post based on a reservation disciplinary case, if any, pending against him may be better by permission or surrender to the council to competent authority cancellation. So
this is for subsequent events, yes. They will not claim promotion, they will not claim any benefits on the basis of their certificates after the deschedulement. That's all. But their service can't be taken away. There's no question.
Not only service, benefits of
this. Supposed to take action. Not there was an interim order. I'm supposed to take action in 2013.
It's a very case.
Anyways.
Couldn't have done it.
No, it says so. No, please. No, it says that you couldn't have.
No, I'm so sorry, my lord. Just kind of look at that.
It says cases pending against disciplinary cases pending against should be withdrawn.
No, 87-88, my lord. That's the subsequent one, Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Please have a look.
So why should we ignore the first one, 2005?
That is also, my lord.
That is why Ministry of Finance, Mr. Mehta. Yes. Yes. Yes.
This was also marked to my lord, Department of Finance.
Yes. Maybe. All right. Maybe.
Maybe. Yes. Right.
The point is, my lord, I am not asking my lord, I am not making any recoveries from there. There's no point.
That's so very benevolent of you,
my lord.
Yes.
Whether my lord, in 2013, when I proposed to take action,
yes, you should have gone and got it vacated on the basis of this certificate. Yes. We'll consider. Don't worry. Yes.
Mr. Mehta, you're seeing how the wind is blowing. It's been blowing long enough by now. Two matters over, reserved. The third one, now the next two. We are also not talking of recoveries. We are talking of cuffing up what is entitled to them on retirement. If you would be talking of recoveries, we would have come down on you with hammer and tongs. So therefore, for pension also and other retirement benefits, the same rules will apply. It can't be any different. So you've argued, give the note if you would, both sides, please. 16 and 16.1. Mayor Vishwanath Pillai on facts is not applicable.
Payment had been made, then your lordships have always protected, my lord. No question of recovery. The payment had been made. But if it is not paid, to direct, my lord, to payment, my lord, then that may not be, my lord, consistent with these judgments, my lord.
All that we have honored is your statement that no adjournment be given in the matter today. Now, no adjournments heard, argued, reserved. That's it. Thank you.
Point out the
single, of course, before before reading, writing this article. Yes,
right. Look at it. Instead, we should look at the other judgment which your colleague was pointing out, and you said that we don't read that first, read Vishwanath Pillai. As a matter of fact, we should be reading that three judges bench judgment of this court in FCI versus which paras of FCI was
judgment, my lord.
Page 29.
FCI judgment, my lord, actually said the entire law, my lord. If your lordship sees FCI, my lord, the entire law has been captured there in that judgment, my lord. They explained, my lord, in some of the cases, 142 power was exercised. That also is explained.
No, we may be persuaded to do that.
In that too.
No, my lord, explains. My lord, that's what I'm saying. That's, my lord, that, if your lordship sees, my lord. But your lordship power under 142 power, who can question, sir?
You have used their services.
No, that there are
not their fault that they got it.
Locations. Where are you reading here?
Page 29.
Huh?
That is Halwa Halvi controversy.
Yes.
The state of Maharashtra became the bone of contention, particularly with regards to persons belonging to so and so community claims, sub-tribe or designated tribe. A division bench of the High Court spoke on the issue on so and so in Milind's case versus state of Karnataka. The division bench held that Halwa Halvi constituted subdivision of the tribe. Halwa Halvi under entry 90 of the scheduled tribes order 1950. Alba Kofis were in the view of the division bench entitled to the status of scheduled tribe on the ground that they were comprehensive designated tribe, maybe so and so. In coming to this conclusion, the division bench opined that it is permissible to inquire whether a subdivision into the tribe, which is not mentioned in the scheduled tribe order, is nevertheless a part and parcel of tribe which is designated. But if I take the lesson to page 31, the last four lines.
Yes, we've read it. That it is by exercise under 142 that the court had passed that order.
In 2000, till this within judgment, the law was that the state government is entitled to. That was changed in consequence of the within judgment. That the circular which protected my employment and consequently directed me to surrender was in person to the judgment.
But master,
the government did find the document. The circulars are the government of the Lord.
Please.
Your central government itself, your minister of finance itself has said something which bind you. Doesn't matter. We deal with that.
Which
if I could respectfully point out,
yes,
the three-judge bench decision of Bahira. Now we have a compendium of judgments. The first item in which is a Maharashtra statute itself. Section 7 is so draconian, or rather drastic, in vis-a-vis the Karnataka law. Section 7 says, if there has been a misrepresentation as to the caste, and if a person secures educational qualification, the qualification itself will be rendered null and void, is what it states.
Right.
Now, the Bahira judgment is an interpretation only of that particular statute, and it only deals with Maharashtra, Bombay High Court cases.
You're saying that the facts of the case itself, it is only
restricted to the state of.
Only on state of Maharashtra.
Yes. So that is a statutory construction. It has no bearing.
I don't see the entire judgment. I can assure the Lord, laying down, my lord, principles of general application, my lord.
Yes.
It may be, my lord, on the Maharashtra statute, my lord. But it doesn't mean that the principles are not of general applicability. Please have a look at the entire judgment, is my respectful submission.
Yes, yes, of course.
I point out, my lord, in my note, my lord, the relevant paragraphs from this judgment, my lord. Because there, my lord, the court has explained where this court, my lord, granted or protected, my lord, particular individuals, wasn't said.
Mehta, this is a case, wherein the state had exercised the power of declaring these communities to be scheduled tribe or scheduled caste. Subsequently, that decision came to be overturned, holding that the state had no power. How can they be faulted for their excess?
Individual.
That is what the basic issue
is. That's all. That's why we.
They are all entry levels.
That's okay.
Whatever.
Please give some submissions.
Give a note on this.
All right. 2 pages by tomorrow evening. Thank you. 17.
This, my friend.
2 days today and tomorrow. Absolutely. Next.
A day after.
By tomorrow.
But,
thank you.
Is the honorable.
Yes, please. We've earned our lunch at least.
I'm tabulated the list of events.
The main stand of the respondent is that he's been exonerated in that criminal matter, right? Proceedings emanating And your stand is that the disciplinary proceedings are on a different footing. That's about it. He's been exonerated in the criminal proceedings.
There is stand. That proceeding, they've taken a plea which is totally
contrary.
Submissions. One is this, that the High Court in the real jurisdiction had upheld the findings.
Yes.
One. Secondly, it has completely misread the portion of the plea which is taken in the before the NSC.
Let's read that.
If I may give the facts to the case.
Yes, please go ahead. Go ahead at your place. Go ahead. So, yes, let's go through it with you.
So, in 1958, precisely 1950,
joint service,
he starts working. Now, between 89 and 90, he suffered punishment on four occasions. This was his past record, which was before the court's filling. Service record and record card. Record card was there on record. Then, in 1996, this is the date, 10th May 1996 is the date of the incident, when the accident happened. As a result of which, two passengers died on the spot and their several were injured. Now, we issued him a charge.
We have one request. It's 4-1. Should we spill it over post-lunch? Would that be better?
Yes.
Now, maybe ask when this is item number 17. Our learned counsels in 18 to... Sorry. All right, then you take it back. We don't want that it should get misplaced. And the request to learn a counsel for the respondent who submits that he would be in personal difficulty if the matter is taken up post lunch. At his request, list on, put it on us and some other day. This is the 2019 matter. Again, November. Now, any mentioning that this date before we rise, please make those mentioning so that we can indicate which matters will be ready to be taken up. Yes, any mentionings by anybody? No. We have passed it over at request. We'll take it up. 10 and 11 were both passed over. We can take it up at 2 o'clock before we start with the rest of the list. Sorry? What about it? Therefore, what are you saying? Yes, so that also we can take up at 2 o'clock. 53 and 54? Both? Only 53.
Okay,
53. So, 54, we are keeping aside. Yes.
The item 11 passed over. At 2 o'clock, I have a specially fixed matter.
Who had asked for a Passover the first time?
I was not here, that's why it was passed.
So now who's on the other side? We'll accommodate. At the request of item 11 order. At the request of learned counsel for the respondent, 1 minute, the matter was passed over on the first call. This said, when the matter has been mentioned before the lunch recess, by learned counsel for the respondent to submit that he would be in some difficulty in the post-lunch session. At his request, list on. Yes, what do you have to say?
This matter, what happened was the respondent died.
We know it was a wife. We just wanted.
Wife is not giving me wakalat. She is not interested in this matter. That's the situation. So therefore,
we
don't.
Even if she is not, we have to put him to terms on the interest and deposit it, and then she can have it collected or arranged for it. It's okay.
But she refused to give wakalat.
We understand she may be in a difficulty, but you will assist us as a counsel, as an officer of the court. You assist us. We will record that. So that will also assist us. It's only a question of now fixing the rate of interest, which should be reasonable. You assist us. We will do it on a date suitable to us, but it will not be taken up today. Yes, any other mentioning?
This therefore after the night is his bench.
Yes,
so we will adjourn it. Who's on the other side? 1 minute, he's mentioning. We are hearing it. Item 19, say at the request of Laura Thompson. You are the respondent. You are the petitioner.